Okay, it's time to talk about death costs. Now, I know death costs are exceptionally polarizing, and if I could get a quick favor from you guys, before you leave a comment, you could watch the entire video. I'm going to be going through how I personally feel about death costs and sort of the lens that I use to look at them and analyze them, and I'm also going to be going through a lot of the popular arguments for why death costs should be in the game and should be as punishing as they are right now, just to kind of play a bit of devil's advocate. After that, I'm going to propose a solution and we'll call it there. And after that point, I'd love to hear absolutely everything about what you guys have to say about death costs. I'm sure you guys are going to have a ton of really cool comments and I'm going to read every single one of them. First off, I am what most would consider an experienced PVMer. I'm not at the top of the top, but I'm definitely in the top 1% of PVMers. And I want to say, before you leave a comment saying, okay, he's a max player, he makes a ton of money, he has access to great GP methods, why is he complaining about death costs? I'm not making this video for me. And I want to get that right out of the way immediately. When you're balancing an MMO like RuneScape, you never want to balance around the top players. Because if you balance around the top players and have a system that works for them, it likely won't work for the majority of your player base. The people you want to balance around are the people right in the middle, the people that are average tier PVMers or are your average users. A good example of this is if you were to balance clue scrolls around them being completed in under a minute each clue, because that's what some people are able to do, I think clues wouldn't be a whole lot of fun. I know there are a lot of people's favorite money-making method in the game right now. I don't think they'd be quite as good if you balanced around that top player. So, under that lens, let's do a bit of a deep dive into death costs. I love PVMing, and the thing I hear most about PVMing as a content creator is how difficult it is to learn and get into. And a lot of that is a lack of good information within the game. I mean, this game barely has a combat tutorial, and that makes a massive difference. But another massive detriment that I hear a lot about is death costs and how punishing it can be specifically for people who are trying to learn. In order to do a proper deep dive into death costs, let's first talk about how the death system currently works. For a lot of bosses in the game, you will enter the boss fight, and for some you can teleport out, and others it's a kill or be killed situation. What will happen is you're now using supplies, most of your gear degrades, and if you are to die, you will then also have to pay death to reclaim your items or lose charge on your ring of death. So either way, when you die, you're losing time, you're losing supplies, and you're then on top of that, losing money. This isn't inherently bad, but as soon as you start comparing it to other facets of the game, you'll very quickly realize that there aren't any other aspects of the game that are nearly this punishing. The general punishment for failing most things in RuneScape is a loss of time. So you lose the time it took to make that progress. Let's say you're doing a clue scroll and you fail a puzzle. Your punishment for failing the puzzle is having to restart the puzzle and go back through it. Imagine if you failed that puzzle and you lost the entire clue scroll. That would be quite punishing. Or what if you took it a step further? If you fail the puzzle during a clue, not only did you lose that one clue scroll, but you also lost the last hour of clue progress you made. That would be considered exceptionally punishing, and that would be absolutely terrible. People wouldn't like that system, and it wouldn't be fun. And that's sort of where things are at for people who are trying to learn PVMing. You're already paying an arm and a leg just to be able to fight the boss and put yourself in a position to kill the boss as effectively as possible. You're right, you could learn the boss in inexpensive gear, or learn the boss with no food and do it that way. But an MMO should encourage and incentivize upgrading your account. And at this stage of the game and in 2021, this punishment for putting yourself in the best place to successfully get a boss kill or to learn something new makes absolutely no sense. And sometimes at this point, someone will say, well, why wouldn't you just use practice mode? Here's the issue with practice mode. A lot of loadouts and a lot of setups will cost you upwards of 10 million coins an hour just to do. And that general cost of PVMing is high enough that as soon as you go into practice mode, you're almost immediately shooting yourself in the foot, as you now have zero opportunity to get a drop from that boss that could offset some of your supply costs. I think when I talk about high death costs, sometimes people have an idea of like a really, really sweaty top PVMer, 100 switches, that is dying because they don't have any food in their invent. And I just don't think that's a fair comparison to make. First off, they're making a playstyle choice. It's very well known at this point that you do not need switches to complete anything in the game. You also don't even need full manual to complete anything in the game. This week, I was able to complete a hard mode Karapak kill in a solo with no food, where not only did I not use any switches, I also didn't fire any abilities. I just pre-made a Revo bar going in full of defensives, and I was able to survive and complete the kill. These switches aren't needed. And this idea that if you fix death costs, well, switches are going to become more required, they're going to be like a firmer meta, I just don't agree with. I think that using switches is and will always be a playstyle choice that you can make. And currently, that one playstyle choice in particular is being unfairly punished. One of the main issues with the death system is it's based around the grand exchange value of items. So sometimes people will make the argument that, well, if you're going to use the top gear, that gear's really good and you should have to pay a higher death cost because of how good that gear is. And to me, this argument doesn't make a lot of sense. And it would make sense if the death cost increase was proportional to the DPS increase you got out of this higher tier gear, but that is simply not the case. I'll use an example of a Drygor and a Kopesh. A Drygor is, let's say, 50 mil, and a Kopesh will be 10 times that price at 500 mil. It's less than a 2% DPS increase, but the reclaim cost on the Kopesh is 10 times higher than the Drygor. That's not risk versus reward. That's just absolutely silly, and it makes no sense in the current state of the game. Another thing that comes up a lot in death costs, especially in high-level PVM circles, is that if death costs were reduced, it would be a lot easier to take on the risk of bringing learners to bosses like Virago and Solak. These are bosses that you can't teleport out of. And if a learner were to make a mistake, which makes perfect sense to do, because they're a learner, and wipe the team, that team could lose their entire hour of profit in a singular mistake. Before long, you can find yourself in a position where you're absolutely hemorrhaging money in order to bring a learner. I know, speaking to a lot of people in the high-level community, that if the death system was a little bit less punishing, it would be a lot easier to take on that extra risk of bringing a learner, and it would make a lot of group PVM experiences a little less tense, because at this point, dying is so incredibly costly that you really can't afford to make a mistake. There's another angle to look at death costs is as a gold sink. And I think it's very interesting that I think a lot of people's perception of death costs is that they're attacks on the top end player. But when you're really looking at it, it's generally just attacks on people who are trying to improve and people trying to learn, whether that's implementing your first switch or getting off Revo or learning how to prayer flick. Those are the people that bear the burden of that money sink. And to me, that makes absolutely no sense to me. It's one very specific niche group that is already providing a significant money sink in the game just by having gear that degrades, because almost all top tier gear does. As of right now, using something like a Reaver's Ring and not having your Ring of Death on, it's effectively not an option for a lot of players, because it's simply not worth taking on a 10 or even a 20 times death cost for a 2% DPS increase in a ring switch. It's once again not risk versus reward. Using the Reaver's Ring is objectively a poor choice in this instance, because it doesn't provide enough benefit to justify that increased risk that you're taking. If you were to cap death costs, you'd find that a lot of players would be willing to take on that risk. Let's say hypothetically you were to cap death costs at double whatever it costs with a Ring of Death. I think a lot of players would be more open to taking that extra risk for double death costs than if it was 10 or 20 times. And the end result of that is actually more people who are reclaiming items at death, which results in an even greater gold sink. Outside of that, and it just being generally weird to tax specifically people who are trying to improve in PVMing, if you really cared about a GP sink in the economy, they would do something about the mass amount of ED3 bots that are allowed to continue farming up to the first boss over and over again. Or they would implement a 1% grand exchange tax. Or, even better yet, they would do what old school did and tax the duel arena, immediately removing trillions of gold from the game. But they haven't done any of those things, because they don't care about the gold sink, and the gold sink clearly isn't that significant. The last point I'm going to bring up is something that I think a lot of people don't know about, but death costs are actually arbitrary. In general, they come from the grand exchange value, and that holds true for a lot of items. Let's say the Saren Godbow. It is a 1.6 billion coin item, and its death cost is linearly proportional to that. But what if I were to put a third age die on my Saren Godbow? A third age die is many billions of coins, but as soon as I applied that third age die to my Saren Godbow, all of a sudden, its grand exchange value is set to 400 million coins. This means that I would have a 5 times cheaper reclaim on a third age die to Saren Godbow than I would on a standard one that was straight from the grand exchange. And this applies to a number of items. It's not just specifically the Saren Godbow, it also applies to the Staff of Sliske, the Zaros Godsword, and countless others, where as soon as they're put into an untradeable state, instead of going off the grand exchange value, it's just an arbitrary number that has been set. For me personally, I have a set of Barrows Dyed Telos weapons, and the Barrows Dyes I put on them have unironically paid for themselves over the past 3 or 4 years of death costs, simply from the cheaper reclaim fees. So to summarize, death costs are unfairly punishing to specifically people who are trying to learn PVMing. They have almost no impact to the top PVMer who has access to great GP per hour rates. For someone like me, I don't make a ton of money PVMing these days because I die a lot, and that's a choice. I'm fine with that. I play this game for fun and I'm not too worried about it. And as long as I'm breaking a slight profit, I'm happy with that. But for anyone who's trying to get into PVMing, whether it's your first kill at a boss or you're trying to improve your kill times or implement a new switch or get onto full manual, It is absolutely unfair. You're just getting dinged in so many different places. All of your gear degrades. You possibly have an instance fee. The boss might not allow you to teleport out. And on top of that, if you do make even the slightest mistake, you're either paying over 1,000,000 coins from a ring of death if you've got the 70 mil for it, and if you don't have that 70 mil for it, you're probably paying even more. The solution I hear most brought up is a kill count based solution. So you'd have free deaths if you were below, say, 20 or 50 kill count. And the reason I don't like this is the simple reason of accessibility. The objective of reworking the death system is to make all PVM-related playstyles as accessible as possible. And a system where the lower your kill count is, the cheaper your deaths are, would incentivize learning a really sweaty method, full manual, all the switches, as early as possible. And it would, in a way, punish those that don't want to play the game that way. They want a more casual stance. They want to use Revolution, or they don't want to use switches. And that should be completely okay. They shouldn't be punished for getting a lot of kill count at a boss, and then possibly at a later point deciding, okay, now I want to turn on the strats and try and optimize things here. I just don't think kill count strongly correlates with how good someone is at a boss, or how likely someone is to die or not die. And for that reason, I don't think a kill count-based solution makes sense at all. But now, when we're talking about a solution, we also need to remember, we're talking to Jagex and RuneScape here. And to me, that introduces two new pieces of criteria. The death solution needs to be both simple to understand and easy to implement. I've seen a ton of very long-winded, complicated solutions to calculate a new death cost, and as interesting as they are, I just don't see them being actually implemented in the game. If it's not an easy fix, I don't think it gets fixed at all. Even though that isn't good, and this should be something that's prioritized, I don't think it will be. So, here's my solution. What if there was a soft cap at 1 million coins, which is right around the point where you're breaking even with a ring of death? After your death costs 1,000,000 coins, it would cost 25% of what it currently does until it reached 5 million coins, which would be the hard cap. What the solution would do is it would remove the 70 million GP barrier to entry that the Ring of Death is, as dying without it would cost a similar amount for a base setup. And as you upgraded that setup and brought some more switches, if you chose to play that way and that was your playstyle, it wouldn't exponentially increase quickly to 10 mil, 15 mil, 20 mil, and even above that. It would hard cap it at 5 mil, and your average death with an endgame PVMing setup would be somewhere between 3 and 5 million coins. It puts you in a place where if you're to make a mistake, or the game is to lag, or your client's going to crash, you're not going to lose a full hour of PVMing profit simply because you wanted to learn a specific playstyle. But anyway, those are my thoughts on death costs. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Feel free to leave a like and leave a comment if you did. And outside of that, Jagex, if you're watching this video, if you are listening to me, it's time to do something about death costs. Please.